Hello children, welcome to our max class. So up to our previous class we have completed 7th chapter, that is fractions and decimals. In our previous class we have learned what is mean by decimal, how to write the decimal number, how to read the decimal number, ascending order, descending order, expansion form, addition, subtraction we have learned, and we have completed the chapter. Next we have 8th chapter, that is data handling. 8th chapter is about data handling. 8th chapter, data. What is mean by data? Data means information. Data is nothing but information. So data handling means collecting of information either in the form of words or numerical numbers is called data handling. Understand? Data means collection of information. Data is nothing but collection of information. Collecting of information is called data. Either that information in the form of words or numbers. Information words lo aina sare, numerical numbers lo unna sare aina sare, manaku kavalsina data ni teeskodam em antarante data handling antaru. Collecting of information is called data. Then it is the example of, it is the definition of data. Then I will take my example and I will explain here. Just now I said either the information in words or numerical numbers. For example, now you have class 6. In class 6, in different subjects you got the marks like this. Now, in class 6 you have 20 numbers subjects. In 20 numbers you got the marks like this. 20, 14, 16, 20, 16, 17, 5, 16, 14, 18, 1, 19, next 5 marks we got like this. Now it is data. It is the data about class 6 marks in subject, in max subject. In max subject you got the marks like this. In the subject of max you got the marks like this. Now how many students are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You have 11 students. For 11 students you got the marks like in the subject of max. Now I want to know how many students got 20 marks, how many students got 18 marks, how many students marks you got different marks, no? Then I want to know how many members got how many marks. Now can you say 20 marks? How many students got 20 marks, Nana? See, here we have 20, here we have 20. 20 marks got, 2 students got 20 marks. After 20 we will count 14. How many students got 14 marks? 1 and 2. Okay, 2 students got 20 marks. Next, 16. 16 marks, 1, 2, 3. 16 students, 16 marks got, 3 students got, they got 16 marks. Next, 20 we have counted already. Next, 16 we have counted already. Next, 17. How many students got 17 marks? Only one student, she got 17 marks. After 17, 5. How many students got 5 marks? Only one student. After 5, after we have 16. 16 we have counted already. 14. 14 we have counted already. 18. We did not count here. How many students got 18 marks? Only one student. Then 19. Come to the 19 marks. Then how many students got 19 marks here? Only one student got 19 marks here. Now see, I have written this data in the form of group. So if I have written the data in the form of group, somewhat it is difficult to find. Same data, if I have written in the form of box, ide data ni nenu group la box la find out chesanu ankonni nana, ela ante like this. See, now here number of students, here marks. Now how many students got 20 marks? 2 students got 20 marks. After 20, what is the next number? 18. We will take 19. 19 marks. How many students got 19 marks? 1 student, she got 19 marks. Then after 19, 18. How many students got 18 marks? 1 student, she got 18 marks. Next, 17. After 18, 17. How many students got 17 marks? 1 student. Next, 16. How many students got 16 marks? 3 students, they got 16 marks. Next, how many students got 15? 15 is there? No. Next, before 14. How many students got? They got 14? 2 students. Next, 5. How many? one student, she got 8 marks. Now, see this box and say how many students, how many marks. Now, how many students got 19 marks? Only one student. How many students got 16 marks? Only 3 students. How many students got less than 5 marks? How many students got less than 5 students? 5 marks means only one student, she got less than 5 marks. See, by seeing this box, you are saying the answers easily. Yes, you are seeing and you are saying. You are not searching like this. That means, if we have the data in the form of group, it is difficult to find. So, if you collect the data in the form of box, then it is, for you it is easy to find the solutions. So, if you find the data in the form of box, then that is called organization of data. What is that? Recording of data. What is this now? Recording of data. It is also same information. It is same information. But here we have collected the data in the form of group. But same data here we have collected in the form of box. When if you collect the data in the form of box, then that is said to be recording of data. What we have to call that? Recording of data. Then by using this recording, then we have to find organization of data. What we have to say? Organization of data. Organization of data means, see how to organize data. Organization of data. Organization of data is nothing but, instead of these numbers, we have to use tally marks. Instead of these numbers, we have to use tally marks. Next, first. First, we will take here marks. Number of students. Then last we will take. So here marks we will take. Number of students. Tally marks. First 20 marks. 20 marks, how many students they got 20 marks? 3 students they got 20 marks. Tally marks means 1, 2, 3. Like this. Then next 19 marks. How many students got 19 marks? Only 1 student. So 1, 2. Then 18 marks. 18 marks. How many students got 18 marks? 1 student. So 1, 1. Then 17 marks. How many students they got 17 marks? 1 student. So 1, 1. Then 16 marks. 16 marks they got 3 students. So 1, 2, 3. Then 14 marks. 14 marks, how many students they got 14 marks? 2 students they got 14 marks, 2 tally marks. See, it is the information about data. If you, data is nothing but collecting of information for anything, then gurinchi aina sare, either that is marks or in a family there are 20 members, they would like to eat like. What the information it may be else, information then gurinchi aina kavachu. When you collect the data in the form of words or numerical numbers is called collecting of data. If you collect the data in the form of group, then that is difficult to you find the answers. So when you collect the data in the form of box, then that is called recording of data. If you want to represent the recording of data by using organization of data, then we have to use tally box. It is the organization of data, recording of data, organization of data. So I'll take one more example and I'll explain again. See here. Now see here, I have taken one example. Now here I want to, now I have collected a fruit shop. In a fruit shop, one person is selling different types of fruits like this. Apple, banana, orange, apple, apples, pineapples, kashmir apples, cherries. He is selling like this. Now I have collected the data information about fruits. Now here I want to find. Now this data in the form of group. Group laga undi I have found like this. Now I want to know how many oranges are there, how many bananas are there, how many cherries are there. Like that I have to find. Now here I have written in the this data in the form of group. So somewhat it is for me it is difficult to find. Now if I want to find how many apples are there, means apple here is there. Here is there, here is there, here is there, like that I have to count. So if I have in the group, it is difficult to find like this. Same data, if I have found, if I take in the form of box, that means like recording of data. If I collect the same data in the form of box, then it is easy to me to find how many bananas are there, how many apples are there, how many custard apples are there. So by using organization of data, we will find how many types of fruits are there, how many types of fruits are there, each type how many fruits are there, we will find now. That is organization of data. Organization of data. By using organization of data, we will find how many types of fruits are there, then each type how many fruits are there, we will find now. Then first, types of fruits, tally marks, number of fruits. Here, first we'll take apples. Types of fruits, first we'll take apples. Then, next we have bananas. Next, oranges also is there. Orange. Next, cherries. Custard apple. Last, we have pineapple. So, how many types are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 types of fruits. Now we'll find how many apples are there by using tally marks. Then total number of fruits we'll write here. Now how many apples are there? 1, 2, 3. Next 4, 5, 4. So he has 5 apples. So how to represent 5 by using tally marks? How to represent 5, Nana? By using tally marks, first we have to write 5. To represent 5, what we have to do? Don't write 1, 2, 3, 4, then count. It is 1, 2, 3, 4. Fifth line should be like this, then 5 apples. Don't write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Tally marks you have to write like this only. So 4 lines, then you have to cut. If you cut that 4 lines, then that is fifth line. 5 apples are there. Bananas next. 1, 2. Bananas. 3. Only yes, 3 bananas. 1, 2, 3. So 3 have to write like this. Next, if you got more than 5, then you have to draw 4 lines and cut 5 lines. Okay. Next, orange. 1, 2, 3. 3 oranges are there. 1, 2, 3. Like this. Next, cherries. 1, 2, only 2 are there. 1, 2. Next, custard apple, pineapple. First, custard apple. Here we have one custard apple. 2 custard apples are there. Tally marks 2, 2. Then, pineapple. How many pineapples are there? 1, only 1. 1 pineapple. So 1 tally mark, here 1. By using this, now we can say total number of fruits are there. 5 plus 3, 8. 8 plus 3, 11. 11 plus 2, 13. 13 plus 2, 15. 15 plus 2, 16. Now total 15, 16 fruits are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 types of fruits, total 16 fruits are there. Like this you have to collect. What the information it may be else. Either that is in the form of numbers, are numericals. Either the data is in the form of numerical numbers or words. But if you collect the data in the form of words, then that is called organization of data. If you collect the same data by using tally marks, then you have to say that is organization of data. Recording the data, organization of data. If you did not use tally marks, then that is recording of data. If you use tally marks, then that is organization of data. Madam, if I got 4 here, for example, if I have 8 attributes, then how to write 8, madam, by using tally marks? 8 nela ani cheppandi tally marks tho. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more 3 is there. 1, 2, 3. 8. 5 plus 3, 8, like this. 8. Then if I have 11 apples, okay, I have 11 apples. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Like this. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 you have to count, then 5th line cut. 1, 2, 3, 4. More. 2 lines you have to form like this. So it is collecting of data and about data. Then correctly, I am directly going to exercise 1. Now see, take out your textbooks, page number 109. In page number 109, we have exercise 8.1. A child kitty bank is opened and the coins collected in the form of demonition. So we'll find, represent the data in a frequency distribution table using tally marks. By using tally marks means like this, we have to find the data. So I'll explain 8.1. Next, first question, exercise 8.1. I have not written the question. Exercise 8.1. A child's kitty bank is open and the coins collected are in the following denomination. Next, types of coins, number of coins. Next, how many types of coins are there? Some 50 coins are there. 1 rupee coins, 2 rupees coins, 5 rupees coins. Then represent the data in a frequency distribution table using tally marks. By using tally marks, we have to find how many rupees are there total. First, types of coins are there. First, we have 50 paisa coins. 50 paisa. How many 50 paisa coins are there in a count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, by using tally marks, how to represent 5? 1, 2, 3, 4. It is 5th line. So, 50 paisa coins are 5. Next, how many 1 rupee coins are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, first here we have to write 1 rupee. 1 rupee coins are 7. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 1 rupee coins are there. Next, 2 rupee coins. 2 rupees. 2 rupees. 2 rupees coins are 2 are there. So 1, 2. Only 2 you have to write. If you got more than 5, you have to cut like this. Next, 5 rupees coins. 5 rupees. How many 5 rupees coins are there here? Only 1. So 1. It is a frequency distribution table of about these coins by using tally marks. Understand? Here I did not write because here the board is not properly, so I have written like this. Don't write, you also should not write like this. Write here only. Then first question has completed. Next, second question. The favorite color of 25 students in a class are given below. Blue, red, green, white, blue, green, white, red, orange, green, blue, white, blue, orange, blue, blue, right, white, red, white, white, red, green, blue, blue, white. Then write a frequency distribution of table using tally marks for the data. Which is a least favorite color of the students? Same like this only we have to find. But how many types of colors are there? Types of colors, tally marks, total number of colors. Okay. Now see, for the second question, the favorite colors of 25 students in a class are given below. They have given like that. Then types of colors are blue, red, green, white, orange. Now here I have counted 8 blue colors are 8. So we have 8 members, 8 students, they like blue colors. So by using 8, how to print tally marks? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means 8 students, they like blue color. Next, red color. 4 red colors are there by using tally marks. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 students 4. Then green. Green they like 4 students. 1, 2, 3. Sorry, here 4. 4. Green also 4. So 4 you have to write as it is. Next white card 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Last orange. 2. By using tally box, 2 students they like orange. Then we have one question down. Which color, which is the least favorite color of the students? Which is the least favorite color student? Orange is the least favorite color. Least favorite color. So like this you have to find. So remaining third and fourth problems are there, you have to write like this only. Third and fourth you have to complete by using tally marks, you have to write like this, okay? Remaining third and fourth are there, you have to complete. If you don't understood, ask to me, I'll explain again. But complete your homework up to here, okay children?